Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable. UTI Mutual Fund and CNBC TV 18 present the Financial Advisor Forum 2017-18, powered by ICRA.
UTI Mutual Fund and CNBC TV 18 took the 9th edition of the Financial Advisor Forum 2017-18 to Vadodara in Gujarat. This year's theme is Riding the Next Wave of Mutual Fund Growth, Mega Trends, Opportunities and Strategies. Industry experts shared insights on how to mobilize young India towards sensible investing, creation and management of wealth through market volatility and efficient use of technology by financial advisors so they can ride the next wave of growth. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Vadodara edition of the Financial Advisor Forum 2017-18, brought to you by UTI Mutual Fund and CNBC TV 18. Without wasting any more time, let's welcome the panelists. If we look back at the year that's gone by, it's been some big ticket structural reforms that have happened in India. There's also been a great confidence in the India growth story, both from a World Bank and a Moody's perspective. On the mutual fund side, the records have all been broken. The average asset under management is higher than ever before, and the number of SIP accounts are also higher than ever before. So, Suraj, perhaps I'd like to begin by asking you to set the context. It's been a great ride in the last 1 year. We're at the brink of a new financial year. Do some crystal ball gazing for us. What are the mega trends that you see emerging in the next financial year for the IFA community?
I must confess that last year has been pretty unique in many ways. First of all, we have seen a very synchronized kind of growth in markets across the globe. It's not just an Indian phenomenon, but it's been there right across the world. So you take any market, you made money. So if you didn't make money last year, you know, I think you are in the very rare group if that has happened. Having said that, I would say from an India perspective, first of all, you know, mutual funds supported by the markets, because they are the crucial, you know, I would say crucial foundation on which everything gets built. So markets were very supportive. One thing unique about the markets last year also was the intra-month volatility was very low. So it was not only that we performed well, but we almost performed like in a linear fashion during the course of the year. So which is very rare, I would say, for markets. You know, markets are supposed to be more volatile than what we observed last year. The second key trend was banks, you know, after demonetization, had dropped rates. So there was a search for yield in the market going on. So investors were wanting to participate in products where they could generate better yields than what they were getting in the banking system. The mutual fund Sahi Hai campaign was adding a lot to the financial literacy program that was going on. Move away from physical assets to financial assets, because real estate, gold wasn't doing as well last year. So I think we found ourselves in a very sweet spot. And as a result, we had this huge growth that we have, you know, got last year. So I do agree that, you know, once you go through such a good phase, the expectation of investors tend to build in that kind of an environment. And managing that, I would say, would become very crucial. I think that's going to be the key challenge.
Do they need to tame the expectations this year?
Well, without doubt in my mind, I think one has to, you know, to be very cautious of where markets are, because in our assessment, markets are a little bit expensive. And but as you know, we always share, for the long-term investors, it may not matter much. But yeah, when you look at short-term volatility, I think you really will have to manage that very well next year.
Firoz, one of the big changes that this budget has brought about is the introduction of the long-term capital gain tax on earnings from mutual funds. How does that change the game for the IFA community, and what's your advice to them? Because this is a point that you know, pretty much every investor is picking up right now with their advisors.
When you look at long-term capital gains, if you're used to and accustomed to as an investor for 13 years of not having long-term capital gains, it's certainly going to dampen the mood. But if you find out the rupee value impact of this decision, then you will be able to clarify to your client very clearly that it's not as big an impact as it seems to be. For example, if I told you three things which you can tell your investors to distinguish and clarify that it's not a big impact. First, the difference between any other kind of taxation and this one is that most other heads, the other four heads of income tax, get paid in that specific financial year. This gets paid at exit. If you defer your taxation, if you defer your exit for 10 years, your effective tax rate comes down from 10% to 5%. If you defer it for 20 years, quite a few personal finance goals are 20 years away. If you defer your taxation by not exiting for 20 years, your effective tax rate is only 3.5%. Because you have the tax amount with you for the rest of the 19 years to compound and then at the end pay. That's point one. Point two, a family of four, let's assume have a 10 lakh rupee investment today, which is a reasonable size customer, will earn 30 lakh rupees in the next 10 years if 15% is the growth rate. He or she, the family, gets almost about 36 lakhs of exemption in the form of 1 lakh rupees. So where is the long-term capital gain? A 10 lakh investor is expected to earn 30 more lakhs in the next 10 years, but has an exemption limit as a family of 36 lakhs per person, 1 lakh rupee for 9 years into 4. So the point being made here is, that's the second point, that the long-term capital gains can be significantly lower than 10%. And the third point is that you can definitely look at the silver lining across the dark cloud, saying that long-term capital losses now become useful, unlike in the past. So these three points, if you actually use to your merit, the effective tax rates are significantly lower and cannot change largely the case of equities anyway.
Rajesh, the other point that insurance companies are now making is that ULIP has become a better product in light of the fact that it remains tax-free. So how should IFAs gear up for that? And what are the trends or what are the sort of drivers that should determine asset allocation?
I think we all should be aware that the first 5 years is as good as locked in. There's no way that you can do any changes to the fund manager or the strategy of that ULIP once it's gone in. So effectively what you're doing at any point in time is that you're locking into something that you believe will not change for the next 5 years. Which brings me to the second point that you asked. We had done a study on whether mutual fund distributors actually add value to customers. We had done that along with Vijay Venkatram, and we presented that at the Wealth Forum conference last year. And if you go to Wealth Forum, you can download this report. And I feel that it's very useful for all of you to utilize the information to talk to your clients in a better way. Primarily, riding on this question, how is it that you're adding value to the customer has been identified in that report. And one of the primary constituents of you adding value to your customers is by giving them the right asset allocation. It is not by picking up a product. It's not by timing the market. It is not by trying to do rebalancing every year. The primary driver, keeping the behavioral aspect aside, was asset allocation. So think about a ULIP and think about how you add value to customers. They're two different worlds. And the other part is always that we've always learned and we've tried to tell that to everybody. Insurance is risk mitigation, covering your risk. Investments is something separate. So don't try to commingle things. So to your customers, you can always talk that language and segregate it. I'm sure you're all good at it. That simple common sense that you want to drive in, we should keep at it.
Right.
Because the moment you anchor the investor's mind to the fact that investment is not insurance, and insurance is to protect unfortunate events or cover certain uncertainties, then the conversation veers to that.
Okay, so let me also bring in Jeet at this point. You're someone who operates right here from Vadodara. So take us through some of the investor trends of this city and perhaps the region. Gujarat, of course, nobody understands finance better than Gujaratis do. So, but how is the uptake of mutual funds here? Traditionally, the exposure to equities has, of course, been much greater. But today, is the scenario changing at all?
You know, mutual funds have seen an tremendous uptake in the past couple of years, especially post demonetization, right? And this is mainly because of the credit goes to AMFI's campaign on, you know, mutual funds, as Surat sir said, right? earlier mutual funds used to be a push product over here, right? We had to push it to the client, but now because of the campaign, it has created a big pool among it has created a pool amongst the retail investors in terms of mutual fund products, right? We deal in both direct equity and mutual funds, and you know, as you rightly said, Gujaratis, you know, are a pro equity market. They feel that they can manage their money better than any fund manager can. But you know, I can vouch that trend has started changing with the inflows that we have started gathering in terms of mutual funds are way more than direct equity inflows. And technology personally has been a biggest enabler for this mega trend, which has changed. And I'll just give you an example. One of our associates, he's based out of Patadi. It's a very small town near Surendranagar. Most of you might not even heard of it. He's clocking in today almost 3 to 5 SIPs on daily basis. Now, there is not a single AMC over there. There is not a single person who's servicing over there. But in spite of that, he's clocking in 3 to 5 SIPs on daily basis, servicing all his clients completely online. Now, that has been one of the biggest changes because of, you know, mutual fund sahiye campaign and technology.
Right. Suraj, a lot of alpha managers have been saying that the coming year will be far more volatile than what the last year was. We've already seen a bit of choppy waters last month. But given this situation, what are your top strategies for IFAs? How should they be hand-holding customers, especially first-time investors, through volatile markets?
I always believe that the most crucial part in our business is that, you know, why do you come to a mutual fund? You know, that basic question, if you were to ask, especially a saver who comes in. And the simplest way I can illustrate this is that, let's assume you can double your money every 5 years, hypothetically, as an example. So when you invest 1 lakh rupees and you double it in the first cycle, it just grows twice, so it is 2x. But the next cycle, the 2x becomes 4. And the following, then it becomes 8 and then becomes 16. So what I'm trying to illustrate here is that if you genuinely want to generate wealth by investing in funds, your time horizon cannot be 3 years, 5 years, 1 year. It has to be 15, 20, 25 years. So I think the first thing the IFA must highlight is don't get worried about the noise the market is creating. Stay invested for the real long term, because that's where you will feel the creation of wealth, you know, which is required. The second important point is that, and that's what really worries me generally, what you see is when markets do well, people shift. So first of all, just think about it. You started with an asset allocation of 60% equity, 40% debt. Now, because equity did well, now you're at 70-30. Now, incrementally, when you're investing and then you put in equity, suddenly you find that now you're 80-20. Now, actually, what you should be doing is, if you're investing, you should be investing in fixed income so that you maintain your asset allocation, because anyway, as appreciation happens, you know, your equity exposures are going up. So my sense is keeping a sense of balance amongst your investors, you know, not letting them get carried away with just recent returns, giving them a perspective that, look, if you made such a great return this year, next year could be a little modest, but stay invested, you know, go to your goal that you've set for yourself of creation of wealth. And if you do that right, I think the investor will always be thanking the advisors for their life, because you really help them create wealth in the long run.
Right. Ajit also spoke a little bit about small towns and, you know, distributors servicing clients in small towns. So in order to ride this next wave of mutual fund growth, how crucial is the role of the tier 2 or tier 3 city going to be? And what are the unique opportunities and challenges in these particular places that IFAs should be watching out for?
One is purely because data has become reasonable. The behavior on the other side, which is generally called the next half billion of the Indian population, has also substantially changed. And with the proliferation of data, what is also happening is that the customers are also becoming impatient. For example, if you look at certain statistics, so that we can connect it to consumer behavior, and that is very relevant in this scheme of growth. Generally, people tend to switch off from a website if it doesn't load properly, even on a mobile device, and if it doesn't load properly in the first 8 seconds. first 8 seconds. Because we start thinking that this website doesn't work. The new generation is becoming very impatient. That's number one. Second, if you look at the innovation in the industry, some aspect of that innovation is connecting to this new generation. For example, you tap on a button and in the next 2 minutes you have the money, or in the next 30 minutes you have that money back into your bank account from a liquid fund. This kind of an innovation we have not dreamt of probably 5 years ago. I mean, we never even imagined that a liquid fund redemption can come so instantaneously to the bank account. So what is happening is that with the proliferation of data, with the reducing patience level of investors, and with innovation that kind of feeds into this impatience, what happens is that the consumer starts expecting a lot of immediate responses. So it would be folly for us to think that the way we have grown distribution over the last 10-15 years would be the way distribution would grow in tier 2 or tier 3 towns. We cannot take our eyes off the fact that the data is changing the behavior. The access to internet, the data packages is changing the behavior. So that's one mega trend that I can and pick up and share. The other aspect is that because of the startup ecosystem in India, today there are at least 30 plus mobile apps which allow access to mutual funds riding on the India stack, which is Aadhaar enabled. So the other point that all of us have to remember is that the next generation, where are they going?
Mobility will play a huge role in,
yes, it does.
In the way.
And it, therefore, the next leap on this next half billion is going to be very different from what we have seen in the last 20 years.
And I'd like Jeet to comment on that as well. You have both of those things going for you. You are in a smaller city relatively, and you've also leveraged technology in a big way in your firm. So share with us some of the best practices that you've put in place to sort of reach out to the wider market here in Gujarat and across.
So as sir said, right, everyone's attention span is going down and down, right? We need to come up with technological solutions which are faster. So even today, KYC, in simple KYC, you know, we all know that to do a physical KYC, it requires 2 to 3 hours of your an advisor's time, you know, running around, filling up the forms, running around, submitting to RTAs and all. With Aadhaar-based KYC, the whole process gets done in 15 minutes flat. Now, that is what the investor is today looking at. And that is what we have to implement today. Because if you are not implementing it, you know, this KYC is getting done on some other website. As Sar said, you know, there are more than 30 websites, 30 apps who are doing eKYC. The investor will go there. And the investor today is looking at, you know, mobile apps. He's looking at convenience at his fingertips. So that is what we are leveraging on. That is what we are focusing on, you know, providing convenience at the fingertips, you know, investing, switching, reporting, everything at the fingertips.
Right. So we're running out of time. And before we close, I'm going to ask each one of you to share one piece of advice with the IFA community here to ride on the next wave of mutual fund growth. Jeet, can we start with you?
Foremost advice is to create trust in, you know, investors' mind. You know, we need to offer them solutions and not products. Just giving out one type of asset class is not going to do this trick. We need to do a proper asset allocation for an investor, and that will be based on their goals. And, you know, offer them as a complete solution instead of offering, you know, single individual schemes.
All right. Well said. Firoz?
I think my advice would be specific to enhancing capability, getting into the depth of it. The devil is always in the detail. So point one which I'm making is get the capability higher. See which are the things which can actually address the client's need. Which is especially for a market like this, 100% equity, not complemented with a risk mitigant, might get the clients out during bad times.
Well said. Suraj?
So my request to all of you would be that, you know, focus on fixed income, stay focused on your asset allocation. It's more important now than ever it was. So especially when markets are a little expensive, I think that's the best time to stay focused on it.
All right. With that, it's a wrap of the Vadodara edition of the Financial Advisor Forum 2017-18. We'll be back next time from another city with another set of eminent experts creating value for the financial advisor community. Thanks for joining us. Goodbye.